Psalm number 23 tonight.
Yeah, baby.
For God has my heart, Psalm number 23.
Yeah.
And I'm trying my best to not preach long. Preacher, you stop me if I go over. Psalm 23, the Bible says, "The Lord is my shepherd."
Yeah,
Psalm
23
tonight. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for
God tonight. Make it easy,
Lord. I just pray, God,
give the unction of the Holy Ghost.
Help
us, Lord, have your ear.
Receive the word.
Oh, God, have your way tonight.
God, I pray that tonight will be the day, God, that you can save us.
Oh, yes.
For it's eternally too late. I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
We come to Psalm 23 tonight. We realize that David is the writer of this
song. Yes.
And when we think about David, there's a lot of things that might come to our mind. We might think about how he killed that giant. And we might think about all the mighty battles that he fought and all the enemies that he conquered.
Yeah, that
the mighty warrior that he was. We might even think about how he sat on the throne as the king, or maybe think about all the psalms that he wrote. But it's easy to forget tonight that David, he didn't start out like that.
Right.
He didn't start out being that mighty warrior. But brother, I'm telling you tonight, he started out just being a little shepherd boy.
Oh, yes.
And he was just trying to be about his father's business and watch over that flock.
Right.
Watch over that flock that his father gave him.
Yeah,
I believe tonight he done what any good shepherd's done. I believe he loved that flock. I believe he cared for those sheep. And I believe he watched over those sheep and protected those sheep. And I believe if it came down to it tonight, he would have even died for those sheep. And I believe that's the kind of shepherd that David was. I believe one day David got to looking around and thinking about all that he was for his sheep as their shepherd.
Right.
And I believe it must have dawned on him one day that just as his sheep had a shepherd, he too had a shepherd. I believe he must have grabbed his pen and grabbed his paper and sat down and said, "I'm just going to brag about my shepherd for a little while."
Yes.
And tonight, with the Lord's help, that's what I want to preach on, bragging on the shepherd.
The first thing
I see in this passage tonight is the proclamation of the shepherd. I like the way David started out. He said, "The Lord is." I believe David, he could have just stopped right there and that would have been enough. I believe he could have just said, "The Lord is," and that would have been sufficient. You say, "What is the Lord tonight?" He's everything we'll ever need. I was thinking about all that David could have said that the Lord is. He could have said, "The Lord is the lily of the valley." He could have said that he's the bright and morning star. He could have said he's the sweet rose of Sharon. He could have said he's the balm of Gilead. He could have said he's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul.
David
could have said, "The Lord is that friend that's sticking closer than a brother."
That's
he could have
right.
said, "He's my rock, and he's
that's
my
it.
Refuge, and he's my strong high tower, and he's my shield of defense." He could have said tonight that he's that shoulder to lean on, he's that safe place to ride, and he's that very present help in times of trouble. And all of that would have been right. All of that would have been good. All of that surely would have been the truth tonight. I sure am glad that out of all the things that David could have said, he stopped right there. He said, "The Lord is my shepherd." The Bible says he's the good shepherd. In another place it says he's the chief shepherd. David, he could have said he's the only shepherd. He could have said he's our shepherd. And if you've been saved by the grace of God tonight, he's your shepherd. I'm glad he's the good shepherd. I'm glad he's the chief shepherd. I'm glad he's the only shepherd. And I'm glad he's your shepherd. And what stirs my heart tonight and what really gets to my soul is that just like David, I can proclaim that the Lord is my shepherd. And I thank God for that tonight, that I'm his and he's mine and I belong to him and I'm one of his sheep. He's a personal shepherd tonight.
That's right.
I wasn't always one of his sheep. Before God saved my soul and came looking for me like we tried to preach on last night, I was just a sheep that was scattered abroad. I was one of those sheep that had gone astray. I was outside the fold. I was standing afar off. I sure am glad tonight that by his grace and by the blood that he shed, I'm now one of his sheep. And I can say that he's my shepherd. I thank God for that tonight. I'm glad I can say the Lord is my shepherd. I'm glad tonight I got one that guides me.
Yes, sir.
I'm glad I got one that cares for me. I got one that protects me. And I got one that leads me and he feeds me and he keeps me tonight. He's watching over my soul. I don't know where I'd be without him, but I thank God. be lost in hell tonight.
Yeah.
But I'm glad that I have a shepherd that's watching over me. And I tell you, there's no wonder David sits down and he begins to brag on this shepherd. I believe tonight when you know the shepherd, you'll want to brag on him.
Amen.
I ain't got time to preach it tonight, but I'm going to give it to you anyway. I want you to notice how David brags on the shepherd. He said, I shall not want. That's him bragging about the provision of the shepherd.
Right.
He said, he maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. That's the providence of the shepherd.
Yeah.
He said, he restoreth my soul. That's the power of the shepherd.
Yeah,
he said, he leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. That's the path of the shepherd.
Yeah.
He said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. That's the presence of the shepherd.
Oh, yeah.
He said, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. That's the protection of the shepherd.
Yeah.
He said, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. That's the privileges of the shepherd.
Yeah.
He said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. That's the preserving of the shepherd.
Yeah,
I don't know about you, but it seems like David, he sure had a lot to brag about.
Oh,
he just sat down with his pen and his paper, said, I'm just going to brag on the shepherd for a little while. And I just thank God tonight that we've been in a meeting this week where people's been bragging on him. I tell you, I just like it when people brag on my shepherd. I like it when they preach on him. And I like it when they sing about him. And I like it when they stand up and testify on him. I'm nothing tonight, but he's everything. If we don't do nothing else tonight, let's just brag on the shepherd.
That's good.
Amen.